journal. This time of the year, it gets dark so early. Like the day is just an accident, and the night. Is how the world really works. Stars and fireflies glowing in the dark. I've never actually seen a firefly. Do you think that matters, Journal? Glowing things are cool. Especially in nature. On holiday in Wales, Gran and I would go to the beach and look up at the stars. But one night, we looked down instead. The stars were shining in the water. It was like the sky got flipped upside down. We took off our shoes and socks and waded into the water. As we walked over the pebbles, they glowed beneath our toes. Gran said it was called bioluminescence. Tiny plankton in the water being moved back and forth by the tide. I knew it was just little creatures, but it felt like magic. I got up very early the next morning. I sneaked into the kitchen, got a jam jar, and went down to the shore to where I'd seen the plankton. Evening, I was so excited. I carefully put the jar on my bedside table. And waited for the night. But it didn't glow. I was devastated. I showed Gran the jar. She laughed. Gran always says,
"You can't put a cork in nature."
They need sunlight and nutrients from the tide. Gran knows about those things. She used to be a marine biologist. Gran bought some special algae that would grow at home. We spent the whole day planning it. Pebbles. Glass stones. Corals. Water. Sand. Company. light. A house. We took pictures for Gran's photo album. For our future selves to remember. How the tank took ages to fill. How we took turns stirring the algae in. How happy we were when we had it all set. Just needs time to develop, said Fran. After 6 days, the algae was ready. I put the tank on my desk and ran my finger through the water. Own bit of magic.
Izzy.
That was Mum. She just got a call. She has to leave now. It sounded really bad. I have a weird feeling in my stomach. Something I don't know how to deal with. We just heard that Gran has had a stroke. I don't want to believe it. I can't lose her. Grace woke from a hazy, distant dream. Something unnatural had stirred her. What's that noise? Elder Ava?
Grace! A giant creature is attacking our village.
Attacking? I thought the fireflies...
There must be something wrong. Get to the tree at once. Hurry!
What creature could have caused this? And suddenly, Grace was surrounded by smoke and cinders. As she hurried past the crackling rooftops, her concern grew.
Hey, Grace, you've got to hide.
You can hide with us.
Broken?
The lift.
She looked at her burning treetop village. This was all she knew. This was home. She needed to get to the fireflies. She needed to keep everyone safe.
Please, Grace, help me out. I'm trapped under this thing. Oh, thank you, thank you. Oh, I'd be so glad to see my feet again.
No, no, no. I need to get to the firefly tree. The bridge was beyond repair. Okay. One step at a time. Grace rushed out to meet it. Soon she would prove herself as the new village guardian. I can do this. Right, Firefly? Right? But she could not deny the creeping terror. The earth yawned below her. This tree did not comfort her. It was as scared as she was. With nobody around to extinguish them, fires burned out of control. The sacred bell lay silent on the ground. Dreadful realization dawned on Grace. Fireflies were gone. A new determination rose in her. She would find. The fireflies.
Elder Ava! Something took the fireflies.
I know. Our people will fall sick without them.
Don't give up hope. I'll get the fireflies back. I'll make everyone better. I promise.
Go. And may the love of this village guide you. Always.
Grace took a deep breath. She knew what she had to do. She was the guardian. She would bring the fireflies back home. The earth could fall away beneath her. But she would not be stopped. This was further than she'd ever been before. And yet it was exhilarating, wondrous, and terrifying. Fear was at her side, and hope in her heart. But things were about to get worse. Much, much worse. But Grace would not slow down. Not for crumbling paths. not for giant monsters. She would make it answer to her, no matter what. She would catch the dragon.
No, wait!
She raced forward. And leapt